deferred. You don't have any, maybe you don't have a lecture for repair of ruptured globe in any courses. You got this situation dependent on experience rather than on lectures. It's very tough to have a lecture in the repair of ruptured globe because it's the barriers, speed barriers. First of all, we have to estimate the problem. How to estimate the problem? We can estimate the problem in the United States in 1980. 2.4 million ocular injuries happen each year. It's a very big number. And high proportion of these are in work and sports, motor vehicle, and so on. Usually in young men, and these people are productive in the community. So losing one eye is a big problem. It's a big social and economic problem. Men are usually more affected than women, but this difference between men and women disappears after age of 70, maybe because of different lifestyle. The work-related injuries represent up to 50% of all ocular traumas, and it can be improved by better working environments. Most of working environments are not safety related. We don't understand in our communities too much about safety. And if you don't believe me, drive your car. Just drive. That's a teaching language. He may understand better by English. Consider, and you answer by English and Arabic, both. From where you are. I have Libyan friends. They understand English very well. She is in this room. We have to estimate the feelings of each other. So I will continue.
Feel free.
Both are from Iraq. Both doctors. I will continue. It's my decision in the last. Work-related injuries. Up to 50% of all ocular traumas. The work practice can improve this situation, and here you have a prophylaxis from trauma-related, from work-related injuries, home-related injuries. In my practice, I find many home-related injuries, and they are more common in people less than 15 and in people over 65. They are related to many things, like hammers, nails, and drills, and even tables. One of my patients was working in her home, and the carpet took her foot. So she fell down, and her eye come to the edge, the corner of the table. So she had a ruptured globe in 70 years old. Sport-related injuries also. Sport-related injuries are important. The baseball in Europe is very important to cause, and it is a very fast ball that lead to severe injuries. Also, accidental impact with the racket and with the tennis ball. Other etiologies like assault, like transport related, like air gun and war related, and revolution related. We have many revolution related injuries in the last 2 years, and me myself had very long experience with this revolution related, especially in the start of revolution. I had many people with injuries, with very strange injuries, and with very strange bullets and shoots. Motor vehicle crashes. I have one of my patients who had bilateral ruptures because of motor vehicle, because the motor vehicle makes the patient just hit the front glass. And one of my patients had unilateral rupture with about 6 operations because of rupture. And finally, she can see now 4.3. So thanks God for this outcome. I have one of my patients who was Chinese. And he had a trauma with هو ماسكها لفوق كده ده بس الخشب دي بتطلع ده بقيس طويل قوي بس الصوت مش عندي لان الموبايل وذ ستولن سبيريتشوال يعني لكن المهم هو بيدبس الخشب في بعضه فبيعملها لفوق كده سو هي هاد ذا نيلز ان هيز آي. طيب سكلير ابشن ناو وي هاف ذا ايتيولوجي ناو وي هاف ذا سكلير ابشن فيرست سكلير ابشن وي سي فير بلانت انجري باي اوبجكتس از لارج از ذا اوربت or larger, as a fist or golf ball. It's usually upper nasal. It's usually 3 millimeter posterior to the and concentric with the limbus, but any type of injury can result. Don't rely on this. You have to examine the eye very well to search for the rupture. Scleral rupture have many things to prolapse, like vitreous, retina, uvea. So if you are excising the tissues, prolapse it. Consider that many things can prolapse through a scleral rupture like this picture. You have here uveal tissue and lens, crystalline lens, and vitreous, and maybe retina. Retina is similar to conjunctiva. When it prolapses from the scleral rupture, it is looking like conjunctiva. Don't open it as you are opening the conjunctiva. Try to close it. Although when the retina is prolapsed, the prognosis of vision is very great. There is something called concealed rupture, and I want this lecture to be somehow interactive because it's the last lecture in the course, right? This is the last one. How many of you heard about occult or concealed rupture? One? Just one? Two? Three. Concealed. Four. Concealed or occult rupture. Okay. It is a very important type of rupture because it can be masked and you can let the patient to go home with no any interference that he had a rupture. How do you know this? Science. Conjunctival chemosis. Look to this patient. See here conjunctival chemosis and subconjunctival hemorrhage and the mass even under the conjunctiva. If you find this, then consider concealed rupture. Concealed means not overt, the opposite of overt. The opposite of clear rupture. Signs. Motility limitation. Why the patient had a motility limitation? Because the rupture may involve a site of insertion of extraocular muscles because of edema, tissue edema, because of orbital hemorrhages. All of these lead to limited ocular motility. Other signs, deep AC, not shallow. Deep AC. Why deep? Because the lens iris diaphragm lose support, so the iris lens diaphragm can come back. And deep AC is converted to the other side. Big debugment may be present. Corneal haze for unknown reason. It is supposed that it may be due to endothelial dysfunction, but it's not well known. But you may find a corneal haze. Dropped visual acuity, unexcellent vision. Relative afferent pupillary defect, hyphema, low intraocular pressure, but it's not essential to have a low intraocular pressure. It may be even high because a blood clot block the leak, the site of leak. The supposed site of leak is blocked by a blood clot. So the pressure may be normal or even high. So not necessary to have a soft tension. And please, don't check the pressure by your digits. The worst method to detect the pressure changes is digital method. In supposed open eye, either post-operative or before repair of trauma, or after even repair of trauma. Don't check the pressure with your digits, because this will open the wound and extrude many contents of the arm. Then red reflex is another sign.
What is it?
Ablation tonometry, if you have. Or indirect signs, like epithelial edema, if you have a high IOP, and endothelial folds, if you have low IOP. Management of this patient should consider CT scan. You will find a finding like this one. The eye looks smaller, the eye looks irregular, so there is a rupture. And if it is a high resolution CT, you may find the discontinuity of the wound. But this needs a special operation. Exploration if suspected cases. You admit your patient to the hospital, and a patient like this should be admitted. And you open the conjunctiva, direct opening, and you tell the patient, I'm going to explore your eye. There may be eruption, like abdominal exploration, you know, in acute abdomen. Now we go to the corneal rupture. By a small object, usually stripping the eye directly, is usually upper nasal, usually horizontal, usually concentric, inward, with the concavity inward. But all of these can be changed. No role for trauma. And this is a difficult in preparation of this lecture and in understanding of this lecture for you. No role. Can be associated with iris or lens prolapse. Can be associated with vitreous hemorrhage, hyphema. The wound is over 4 millimeters is usually not coacted. It is usually open wound. About 4 millimeters. Rupture in operated eyes. This is a very specific situation. Look at this. Rupture in an eye that have done LASIK. I have one of my patients with bilateral ruptures. He was a Chinese man working in some company. And he had a bilateral rupture. And he had performed LASIK before. The flap of LASIK will definitely change its position. Okay. The problem it simulate epithelium, so you may consider this a loose epithelium to remove it. Don't do unless you are talking a very good history from the patient and you know that he is not doing LASIK before. It was found that after 3 weeks of the operation, the trauma that affect the normal eye will affect the eye with LASIK. Okay, don't be afraid of doing LASIK because of potential trauma effect. The potential trauma effect will be equal in LASIK eyes and normal eyes after 3 weeks. Take a good history, as I told you, and good irrigation of the bed of the flap. If you find that the flap is moving from its side, you have to irrigate the bed very well to take the epithelium, because the epithelium, if it's stayed in the bed of the flap, it will make a big problem after repair of rupture. And you need to elevate it again and repair again, and so on. Consider infection. This is not written in the slide. Consider infection. Sometimes you have infection beneath the flap. And the flap may be in need for suturing. If it stayed for a long time corrugated, it will not flatten by itself. It needs suturing. Suturing away from suturing of rupture. You suture the flap to the bed, like lamellar keratoplasty. Rupture in operated eyes also may be in a previous cataract patient. The patient have done extra capsular before. Here. The wound is extreme weakness point. And the IOL can jump to the vitreous, can jump to the anterior chamber. And the most strange that I found once, IOL jumping beneath the conjunctiva. If you don't find the IOL, search for it. You may find it subconjunctiva. sorry that most of the patients of rupture come to me in urgent situations, so I don't have immediate photography. Foldable IOL in pediatric are not stable. In pediatric age group, I advise you don't put foldable IOL. No need to put foldable IOL because the child are more exposed to trauma and the IOL is more exposed to movement. Eyes with phaco behaves like normal eye after 1 month. So it's one advantage of a small incision surgery, phaco emulsification, I don't mean a small incision cataract surgery, I mean phaco emulsification. One advantage of phaco emulsification is that wound, even if the eye is exposed to trauma, it behaves like the normal eye after 1 month, like lazy. Glaucoma is a big problem, glaucoma-operated eyes. The glaucoma-operated eyes, you have the flap is an extreme weakness point because you know that the flap is not healed, actually. So the flap can be torn completely. I have one of my patients who had a complete tear of the flap. All of the flap is lost. So I have a big tissue loss, about 4 by 4 millimeter. But I was lucky in this patient because his other eye was non-seeing from glaucoma also. So I took a batch scleral flap from the other eye to repair this one. So repair of rupture globe needs extreme experience. Don't go to it without extreme experience. So till now, I'm recording my name in the casualty in my university hospital to help people with rupture globe because it do not need a junior staff. Maybe help it, maybe assisted by a senior staff. Okay? Because you may find everything in trauma. Posterior segment surgeons are more liable to intraocular hemorrhage. If they are traumatized, they are more liable to intraocular hemorrhage. The wound can be open and the eye is very easy to collapse, especially if the silicone eye was removed recently. Also, diabetic eyes are more liable to intraocular hemorrhage. If the wound is opened in a silicone removed eye, I have two of my patients who had extreme collapse of the eye. One of them read on the autoref and she was high myope, plus 18. So I found the sclera and the retina behind the lens, just behind the lens. Complications of open rupture. What are the complications? What are the possible complications? So you go to the operating room as early as you can.